I was, I joke, you know, even though I joke with it when I said it about black men being concubine, and the guys that really do this kind of stuff already know what I mean. What you're doing is servicing her, okay? You are the concubine, not her. So if you're the guy that goes from woman to woman to woman, and you lay pipe, okay, you think that you're doing something special. It's that you're no different than a woman that does exactly, goes to man to man to man, does the same thing.
Exactly. I'm glad you said that.
You're a concubine. Some people get upset, you know, some guys got upset. And it said,
that makes the woman the prize. That makes her the
only, you know what the only difference is, and what really makes a man, is that when a woman does it, she gets paid.
Yeah.
If you do it, we get
sometimes.
Hey, what? You get a meal sometimes?
You get a meal sometimes.
Well, I said a bill. You get a bill.
A bill. Okay. Okay. That 18 euro that they that you get to pay out an annuity, huh? For 18
years. Yeah. For 18 years.
Exactly.
Because I actually said that. Angle said who I said it to. Actually said that. I said I was actually raised, you know, I was not raised. What I'm saying is in my formative years, in my 20s, I was actually around a lot of old school Max players, right? You know, that told me how the game works. And they would womanize. They'd have four, five, sometimes even six women, right? But guess what wasn't empty at the end of the day? It was their bank account. They didn't do it. They went out womanizing and busting wounds for nothing. Mm-hmm. So I'm thinking, if you're gonna do it, if you're gonna have 20 women, if you're gonna have 20 women, there's no reason for you to be broke.
Well, if you're gonna act like a prostitute but don't get the money, something wrong with you.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
I mean, like anybody would be after scolding a hoe for working for free. But if you're a man, it's totally okay. That's
the stupid shit that's going on. What are you getting, man? I get to knock out all these women's backs. I said, oh, really? And that's your reward, huh? Okay.
Okay, the time you're going to waste, the time you put in to do that shit, but you can really think you're winning.
Fuck that. Yeah, well,
super chat. He's spreading one, fellas. All right, keep going.
Yeah.
Some guys get mad at me, but said, you know what? Hey, you know, I always said, even I said it to SYSUPM guys, I belong to the truth, okay? So, and I know some guys, you know, on this side got mad at me with my stuff I say, but it's equal. I said, if it's not true, let me know. It is what it is. So I belong to the truth. I said it to the player guys. I said, if you were using these women or you're with these women, and then you for some kind of gain, okay? Whether it's monetary, lifestyle, whatever it is, some kind of gain. So you got five or six women, you're getting some kind of gain. I can understand it. If not, that's a lot of time that you got to put in to go from woman to woman.
I don't know what he's doing.
Exactly.
I don't know.
Yeah. But they ain't got nothing to do with a lot of them. So they'll give up their time, but that just says that man doesn't really value himself that much.
At least a doggone convict that's a homosexual gets a meal and a place to stay and a car to drive, okay?
That's true.
If he's doing the exact same thing, but at least he gets a meal, a place. I can understand why he's trying to survive, okay? And that's the way he survives. I have no problem with a homosexual, okay? If it keeps you off the street and you can survive until you can do better, you got to do what you got to do. Okay, I understand that, but the dudes that doing this and not getting a reward, I don't get that.
Yeah.
If you got more than two, I can understand if you got two. Okay, if you're a man, it means you got one or two. I can understand that. Okay, variety, men do that. But if you got five, six, seven, come on.
Wait. What is a woman to a man? And what is a man to a woman? What is it, the same thing? What is a woman to a man? And what is a man to a woman?
Well, a woman to a man to me, based on my experience and my understanding, especially now at 43, mm-hmm. And dealing with all the women I've dealt with, not even just in relationships, just running the salon, running business, doing business transactions,
yeah,
serving them as clients and so forth and so on. But a woman to a man is really to help him. Like they actually, the Bible says, help me.
Yeah.
And she needs to be really in tune to what the man needs to serve humanity.
True.
And to support that, whether if she's my client, she sees that I'm doing good by the staff, she's supposed to even, if my client sees that, she's supposed to do little things as a woman to help that maintain and bring forth a better situation for others to come work, whatever that may be.
Yeah.
That's women have that that in them.
I agree.
See, she's supposed to anyway.
It's true.
She's supposed to do that, the right woman. Which is why they have a lot of success, because on the flip side, a man to the woman is, you know, being able to show her things and experiences that she can't do.
Yeah.
And the right woman will see that and actually get behind that and support
and
that.
And receive that. Yeah, Gorgeous Dre said that, you know, in his marriage has been able to sustain itself because he said, I constantly show my wife that I could do things better than she can. And so to an untrained ear, that sounds sort of like, you know, weird. You know what I mean? Like, are you trying to break your wife down? But in essence, she should need you.
Yeah, she should.
And when she feels like she doesn't anymore, then it's pretty much game over. Sometimes a woman, she still needs you and thinks that she's gotten to a certain level and now she doesn't need you anymore. And so they try to discard of the, you know.
Sometimes they think that they have enough.
Yeah.
From what you imparted in them.
Yeah, I do.
They really believe that. So men need to understand that when you're filling her up or trying to give her your best and show her things in her life to increase her value as a woman, a lot of times it actually shows in a lot of respects. So when they go out, dudes are looking at them extra like, wow, man, that woman's about that chick. But like you told me a while ago, what they were looking at, a lot of those dudes was looking at you, really. How they look at us when we walk in restaurants, when I'm looking just clean with my gear on. So if a woman is dealing with you, that part of you is in her.
Yeah.
And so when she's away from you, dudes are soft choosing or hard choosing, whatever, she's thinking it's her.
Yeah, she does.
But it's actually you.
Yeah, it is.
That those dudes.
What's interesting is that the sun, which is the masculine principle, is responsible both for daylight and night light. The sun is responsible for both. Because when the sun is on the other side of the world, it still lights the moon. It's the sunlight. So the sun is still responsible for moonlight. So it lights the night and the day. And, you know,
yeah, that's
I never
true.
Heard anybody put it that way before.
I never thought about it either, yeah, like
but,
that.
Yeah, but that relates to her reflecting your light.
Yes.
And that reflection is also if you're out of town, if you're abroad, that light should be reflected in the household with the kids.
Yeah.
She's supposed to be a reflection of dad. And the hierarchy should always be relevant in that household. You know, the kids are always reminded, even if dad is abroad, that, you know, your dad, you know, yeah, you know.
Because there's something to that as a child, and I think sometimes children may not be able to say it or even express it, but when dad is not around, that's what I think. Now, I've thought about this through the years. That's why I believe that it's a certain excitement that a child has when the dad is gone. That woman upheld her, that side of him and holding it down like she's supposed to him with the kids.
Right.
The child has a certain level of excitement when that's you come true. Around. I think it's just a buildup from seeing mom, but the reflection of him through the mom.
Yeah, and her excitement.
Yeah.
And love for him.
Yeah.
It's passed down to
it's
the
passed
child.
Down, yeah.
And I think that's, you know, when
that's
I...
That's true.
You know what I'm saying? When I first got with my ex, the first thing... One of the first lessons I taught her was I used to pay attention to how she used to bad talk her son's father. And she used to talk to him like he was really just a piece of shit. I mean, she talked to him like a tampon that she just took out of her, you know, vajayjay, you know, and damn sure didn't need that anymore. So you know, put that away. She talked to him like that. And a lot of women do when they lose respect for a man, you know, or maybe they weren't cultivated to respect men, right? And the first lesson that I taught her, I said, your son is going to suffer from self-esteem issues. Now, I came into their life when he was like 9. And I told her, all of his life, he's heard you badmouth his father. I said, when he brushes his teeth at night, he's looking at the reflection of what you hate.
Wow.
And I said, you think that you're saying these things to his father, but you're saying them to him too. So there's no motivation in him to be a man because none of the women in his family fucking respect those. Mm. And she, you know, that was one of the first lessons I taught her. You're actually teaching him to hate masculinity because you don't have no respect for it. You never submitted to it. So, you know, and then it was interesting, case in point, to prove that that was true. Later on, when he was around 15, he came to me and he said, Warren, he said, I struggle with self-esteem. He noticed it in himself.
Wow.
Same kid, except he's 15 now. He said, I struggle with self-esteem. And I said, and I had to tell him the truth. I said, well, when you were a kid, your father wanted his family. When he figured out that your mom was pregnant with you. And he told her, well, I want my family. And she basically laughed in his face.
Damn.
And all he heard all his life was he wasn't paying child support like he should. He wasn't this, he wasn't that. But the truth of the matter is, he wouldn't have had to pay child support because he asked for his family. He asked her for his family and she told him no. And so when I told her that her son came to me and said, well, I struggle with self-esteem issues. And I told her that I had to tell him the truth. The weirdest thing was she started crying, hearing that.
So she started crying.
And those were tears of guilt because she as tears were coming down her face, she said, almost like she was on some prophetic shit. She said, I always knew. Now, tears are streaming down her face at this moment. She said that his father wasn't ready to be a man and to, you know, and this and that. But I'm saying, I didn't say anything to her about what I said to him. So that struck a nerve.
It struck him, yeah.
Well, she even admitted that those tears was her admittance that she was really the reason her son lacked confidence in himself. And that's a mainstay in the black community.
Yeah, it is.
The mainstay.
And it has to, as men, you have to really look at every situation like that, any woman that you're dealing with,
you do,
and just see, like you said, like interviewing her, and that's understanding, like, even if she has a child, you know, I mean, you don't want to do that to deal with a woman with a child, really, at this point,
right?
But if so, you got to look at that whole dynamic,
you really
do. Situation. Where's that man at? What happened?
Yeah, and how does she refer to him?
Yeah.
What words does she use when she speaks of him? Because the other end of it is, and men don't understand this, 9.6 times out of 10, it's gonna be you on the other end of that phone receiving the same vitriol. That's the part that men don't understand when the pussy is new to them and the relationship is new. Eventually they're gonna be on the other side of that phone when she loses interest in them. And men have to, that's why we say in the pimp game, hoes come going. You have to become used to a woman.